his bike all day through the countryside by starlight from the Milky Way. He finished his ride. His 100-mile journey required persistence. Now let's see how he tracked his distance.
Here are the numbers 1 through 9 on a diagram we call a number line. They're represented by lengths and mark with points spaced equally apart. Now if we extend this number line one whole number to the right, we'll find the next number that we'll mark is 10. Now let's extend it again and again. 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. Then my ride ended at 100. But the pattern continues forever ahead.
When numbers are shown as distances represented on a number line, helping us find sums and differences.
Now Rob's back home hanging out with his mom. They are winding down the day at numberrock.com. They pick a song about number line skills, a replays that thrills, and Rob's mom says,
"This is chill.
We can jump forward on number lines, solve problems with addition signs. Let's say 11 to 29, jump 1 and then 10, 40 is the sum we'll find.
And we can subtract 11 to rewind, which will take us back to 29.
We can jump backwards on number lines, solve questions with subtraction signs. Let's subtract 12 from 25, jump back 10 and 2. 13's the difference we'll find.
Now add back 12 to 13, and we will arrive at a sum we've seen, 25.
There are many instances when numbers are shown as distances represented on a number line, helping us find sums and differences.
Now here's just one last remark about the distance between each mark. We can call them spaces, but to be technical, their correct mathematical name is an interval.
There are many instances where numbers are shown as distances represented on a number line, helping us find sums and differences. Whoa, whoa, whoa.